7 o'clock service, a moderator hour. First of all, we thank all of you for coming out, and we pray that the Spirit of the Lord will move on our hearts tonight, and we will just enjoy the service. And we have a scheduled program. I don't know, we have enough to get to table one, but if you don't have one, we will be starting our service off with the hymn, Blessed Quietness. And after we have a welcome, Sister Gail Johnson, Sister Ruth Wise, and which we have scripture, Sister Patty Morgan. So let's start off with him. Him, blessed quiet. We have a musician in all of it. Appreciate you coming forward with not me. You were God gave us.
Descended into the lower parts of the earth. And who descended is also the one who ascended far above all the heavens, that he might fill all things. And he himself gave some to the apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers, for the equipping of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Matthew 28, verses 18 through 20. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the earth. Amen.
Amen.
God's word, God's blessing, God's
word. May be seated. At this time, I'm going to call the first vice president of the Congress, David Kennedy, to come and give us a prayer.
Serving the night, brother, that night. We want to
battlefield. We want to let them know tonight as we go out, amen, go out with a bang, as the Spirit of the Lord, amen, take them to another level. And I wonder if you would just stand for a moment and shake somebody's hands to the Lord in this place. Come on, come on, the Lord.
Church. Let's come and see what we're all about. It's okay, I'll be there next Sunday. So I went there next Sunday, and I'm still there 18 years later.
Amen. Amen.
Now, that's a testament of how persuasive he can be. He is a man of God. Amen.
Amen.
As I said earlier, he is my friend as well as my pastor. There are times when things don't go well, and I'll talk with him, and he said, "Me, just hang in there." So I've been hanging out with him for 18 years, and to God be the glory. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Reverend Fletcher, he was born in Atlanta, Georgia, to Mr. and Mrs. Johnny Fletcher on a blessed August day in the year of our Lord, 1959. Reverend Fletcher graduated from Old Smith High School here in Atlanta. He continued his education to St. Augustine College in Raleigh, where he received his Bachelor of Science degree in Business Administration in Marion County. Now, that's why he knows all about the money. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. He matriculated at Lutheran Rites Theological Bible College and Seminary in Atlanta, Georgia, where he received a Master's degree in Church Ministry. He also received his Master's of Divinity degree May 18, 2007 from Luther Rice as well. Reverend Fletcher received his call to the gospel ministry in 1994 at Mount Zion Second Baptist Church in Atlanta, where he served faithfully as the minister of evangelism and outreach. He is actively involved in the community in which he lives. He's also a member of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, a member of NAACP, a member of the PNBC Progressive National Baptist Convention, and the New Era Missionary Baptist Convention of Georgia. Reverend Fletcher was called by God in July of 1999 to Eastern Heights Baptist Church, now Downstreet Community Baptist Church, as the church pastor. The church later became Downstreet, as I just said, where he served as senior pastor. He strives to exhibit spiritual leadership and dedication to Jesus Christ in his daily life. Reverend Fletcher is married to his college sweetheart, Stephanie Savine Fletcher, and is the father of one son, Elijah, and the guardian of two beautiful girls, Brianna and April. Reverend Fletcher believes that the church is an organism established by God for the purpose of teaching and equipping people for Christian living and service. He says, "Giving God the glory for all things is my passion." Again, I'd like to present the song in the room to others. Pastor Marques L. Fletcher, Pastor of Downstreet Community Baptist Church, as well as the moderator of the Atlanta Missionary Baptist Association. And the next voice you will hear after the choir comes will be Pastor Fletcher. Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye.
It took a while for me to catch hold of it. But now that I got it, for the rest of my life, I'm going to serve the Lord.
Say that.
Tonight I want to share with you from the depths of my heart.
I'm grateful.
I'm going to share with you because God has called me to preach His word. To this august fire. first thing you might notice at the airport is throughout all of the terminals there are banks of TV screens. Some of them are for arriving flights. Some are for departing flights. If you're at the airport to catch a flight to somewhere, you have to look at the departure time. You have to find your airline and the flight time. Then you have to find what gate it is that you are about to go to and find the right place to catch your plane. I realize tonight that I am at my departure. My departure is at hand. My flight time has already been determined. My gate to leave is in the historical Friendship Baptist Church of Atlanta, Georgia, and I have my ticket stamped by Sister Morgan, Sister Gallagher.
Come on, preacher.
Sister Gallagher and Sister Johnson and Deacon Sands have already stamped my ticket.
All right now.
And
right.
Deacon Hope, the flight attendant, is to tell me that it's time for me to catch my plane.
Come on now.
When the gates swing open, then Deacon Hope will allow me to get out of here and fly away.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's
come on, preacher.
But because I'm departing, I see an arrival at the gate in this Friendship Baptist Church in the form of the Reverend Dr. Ulysses Ponder, the new executive staff and his marching order among God. I'm excited because while I wait for my airline gate to open, I want to leave you at Atlanta Missionary Association with some words about this journey that I'm so excited about. And I want you to know tonight that I want to leave you with, just as I'm waiting to depart, and Deacon Hope is going to open that door, and I am going to get on my plane and fly away. But before I get on my plane, I see the arrival of this week, oh God. I pray that you will forgive me God, as you take me forward, Lord, I pray, God, that you would say what you want to say and do what you want to do, that your name would be glorified, magnified, and lifted up. And I will be so careful to give your name honor, give your name praise, and give your name glory. Let the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. For it's in the name of Jesus the Christ we do pray and ask it all. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Church say amen again.
Amen.
When I first came into this church, I came to have service with them on their day that Friendship marched into this house, Hollow Homes house. And when I walked in, I noticed that the dignity that was displayed throughout this church. And when the council of preachers came into and filed into the room, each one of them had on their robe, their garment. And so I wanted to let Dr. Wills know that this is a place that is hollowed out for the presence of God. And I want to thank him for allowing us to come and be a part of this holy place. Let's give the Friendship Baptist Church family a round of applause. Therefore, my beloved brother, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. That one verse touches on hope that we enjoy as children of God and what that hope accomplishes in our life. That one verse tells us that we have a hope that we can enjoy as children of the living God. This verse can help us dedicate ourselves to walking before the Lord in absolute confidence of the hope that is within each and every one of us. Looking around the world,
preacher.
It's right there.
It's right there.
Oh, you don't believe me? Look at the text. Look at the text.
Come on, preacher.
Yeah. That's why he said, "Therefore, hear my word,
seated, settled, and firmly situated.
Yes,
it reminds us that we ought to be rooted and grounded in what we believe and hold on to that truth.
Yes,
we ought to be seated firmly in our personal convictions.
Yes.
The bottom line is this: if we are to be seated, without that we have no hope, because he said you can't waver on me. I'd rather that you be either, I'd rather that you be hot or cold. But if you wavering on your conviction about me, he said, I'm gonna speak.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When our hope is real,
yes,
it causes us to be stable in our faith.
All right.
And in our walk.
Yes, sir.
What you believe?
Yes.
That's the question. Why do you believe what you believe?
Yes.
Faith comes by hearing.
Yes.
Hearing by the word of God.
Yes.
And how can he hear without a preacher? And how can he preach except he be sent? That's why you come here tonight, to hear a word that will encourage you, that will equip you, that will empower you to face this world that we have. We can do it with everything we have for his glory.
everything we have, time, money, energy, talents, gifts, body, mind, spirit, everything we have should be invested in nothing but Jesus. Our prayers, our praise, our thanksgiving should be giving hands and feet that as we lay everything we have at the feet of the Redeemer and say, Lord, use me. Lord, use me. Lord, use me. I wish Paul was here. He would say it like this in Romans chapter 12. He would say, I beseech you, brother, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice unto God and be not conformed. This world will be transformed by the renewing of your mind that you might prove what is that good and perfect will of God. Is there anybody ready to lay down their life and live for God?
Well,
he says, always abound. Let me see that. There are some abounders in this room. I said there are some abounders in this room. But if you don't want to tell God amen, I can go to the animals. And because the Bible says, having been compassed about by great clouds of witnesses, let us lay away every sin that so easily beset us.
Come on, preacher.
Yeah. know.
Yes.
Y'all see that? Paul says, we know that our work for Christ matters. There is no sacrifice, no struggle, no self-denial, no valley, no work goes unnoticed, and none will fail to pay eternal benefits. Only what you do for Christ is going to last. So keep on praying. Keep on serving. Keep on living for Christ. What you do for him in his name, that text says, is not in vain.
Yeah.
That is not a waste of time. It means that it is not an exercise in futility. He sees it all. And he knows it all.
Yeah.
And one day he will reward it all. I said he sees it all.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now just because your folk don't follow you, you go on anyway.
Yeah.
You don't worry about who's stopping you. You just need to go and do what God calls you to do. Don't worry about God's still working on them.
Yeah.
But what you do is don't get caught up in the mess.
Yeah.
Just keep on going. Striving to do what God calls. That's a missionary, not this association to do.
Yeah.
One day, we will all get rewarded.
Amen. Yes. Right.
You know, believe it, he says in Revelations 22 and 12, he says, now, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according to his work that shall be. In other words, he's watching. And if we are doing all we do for him and his glory, we can be sure that he sees it all. And we can be sure with confidence that God will give us our just reward.
Yeah.
He said, I'm coming, and when I come, our reward is in my hand.
Yeah.
And regardless of how you got to go through the struggle, because sometimes the road we walk is going to be a hard road.
Yeah.
Sometimes the burden we bear are heavy. Sometimes the work we call to do seems to be endless and unrewarded. That word used to describe that kind of patience, that kind of labor, is the word labor.
Yeah.
It means an intense labor united with trouble and toil.
Yes.
What he was saying, thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee
Jackson, Poplar Springs Baptist Church, second.
Been motion by Dr. Wood and Sister Jackson that this message, amen, that we heard tonight, that lifts the message will now stand through. Amen. Can we get a word of a question? All in favor, just say, praise the Lord.
Recorded Secretary, Sister Gabriel Jackson Walker, Tabernacle Baptist Church. Assistant Recording Secretary, Sister Fletcher, on my welcome back to the church. Our responding secretary, Sister Suzette Young, Papa Spring Baptist Church. Assistant Chaplain Secretary, Sister Mary Reese, Sister Child Baptist Church, John.
Officers of the Ladies Department, Reverend Justin Cattle, President, Deacon Charles Hawk, First Vice President, Deacon William Johnson, Second Vice President, Deacon Lester Copeland, Treasurer, Deacon Jerry Hicks, Secretary, Deacon Anthony Rogers, Assistant Secretary. Assistant Treasurer.
What a beautiful sight. That's what I'm talking about when I say we have a very bright future here at the Annapolis Missionary Baptist Association. I don't take this assignment lightly because it's given to me by God. Just want to charge each leader, first of all, to live with integrity. Look up at me. Live with integrity. Because integrity is the single most important thing a leader can have. It does not matter about your ability. If you have and you don't have integrity, your ministry will ultimately fail. I believe that God is on the lookout for men and women who is quiet enough to get his message from him and brave enough to carry that message throughout your lives. Secondly, as leaders, I charge you to deal, to labor with dignity and diligence. Labor with dignity and diligence. In other words, you all not live with mediocrity. You should always live above the rest. Half-heartedness will hurt the body of Christ. Show yourself to be faithful in the job that God has called you. Thirdly, I charge you to lead your divisions, your department, with vision and passion. Because a person does not care how much you know until they know how much you care. Show this body that you care about what you are doing. Finally, I would like to charge you by saying, have fun with your freedom as a leader. Person don't want a stuck up, rigid, that they can't even talk to you. Have fun. Don't be so holier than thou that someone cannot touch you. Have fun with your freedom. Love and cherish what you do, that everyone around you can see the love of Christ within you. If you agree with all of those charges, I'd like you to just repeat after me, I will. With the help of the Lord. And this time I'm going to ask the president of the New Era State Convention to come and give us our installation. Right here in front of me. I want
Reverend Palmer, you're the wheel. You're the spoke in this wheel. Each one of you are spokes to support the wheel. But I don't want you to forget that he is a wheel in the middle of the wheel.
We are your people. We ask it all in the name.
we yet stand, I want to ask everyone to stand now. I recognize my good friend, the Reverend Pastor Samuel Pearson. We're working on him again into the AMBA. He's the pastor of the Community of Love Baptist Church. We're really working on him to consider making this his home place. Amen. Amen. You got something for me today? Amen. Amen. All of the preachers at Young Street, Reverend Tory, listen, put your hand on one of my preachers, the minister of our youth, Reverend Reynolds and his wife. Put your hand on their name. God bless you. They're over our seniors that they have the senior nursing home ministry. The Reverend Marjorie Bitson, she's right here in front of us. And then it's Reverend Fletcher. Amen. We just continue to grow the kingdom. Amen. Let's hear from this new remodel. God bless you. Moderator, Fletcher, and with the MBA, we want to let you know we appreciate you. The job you've done for us, we pray to God for you. Pray that it's not, we can't thank you. But we can let you know we appreciate you. And this is a token of all you in association. God bless you.
Amen. And if you would grab someone's hand, I thank.
thank my musicians for being here. He was on vacation, but yet he decided to make sure he was here for tonight. Right? And everybody grab hands as we pray. And at Young Street, our doxology will proceed afterwards. Father God, we thank you for 115 years. I pray, oh God, that you will continue to be with us as we carry out your vision and your purpose in which you have designed and ordained for this association to go. I pray, God, for all of our sick that were not able to make it tonight. Oh God, I pray that your hands of grace and your hands of mercy will continue to provide counsel, leadership. God, I pray now in the name of Jesus for every pastor that represents this Atlanta Missionary Baptist Association. I pray that you would be with them in a powerful way, that they may be able to preach and be a shepherd to your people. I thank you, Lord, for allowing me the privilege of being able to be your armor bearer in this Atlanta Missionary Baptist Association. Now may the grace of God, sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, would rest, rule, and abide henceforth now and forevermore. Let us sing together. Praise God from
God bless you, God.